Today, our problem is distance and level difference between two inaccessible points. The last class we have discussed with the same problem, but except level difference. Today, the problem we solved that distance and level difference between two inaccessible points. The main difference between these two problems, here we take the vertical reading also, vertical reading of inaccessible points P and Q we take simultaneously with the horizontal reading. Then we can calculate the distance between PQ and the level difference between PQ. First set up a line approximately parallel to inaccessible point PQ. And you can see the point P and Q are inaccessible point according to our question, but they are placed a wooden peg and a nail on that point. You can see how it placed. This is point P. You can also see point Q. B says this problem is distance and level difference between two inaccessible points, but you have a question how we get there. That's a question for academic interest, but we get there and place a wooden peg and a nail for theoretical experiment. B erect instrument at station A, done all preliminary adjustments, and we set horizontal for taking horizontal angle. We set all the adjustments and placed 0 0 to point P. The same time we take the vertical reading. For that, rotate the telescope on the top of the wooden peg, top of the nail that are placed on the wooden peg. So you can place it and focus it. After, you can clearly focus the point. You can take the reading from the vertical circle. There is a two verniers there, vernier C and vernier D. And from we take the reading from vernier C, and the reading is angle of depression, because the level line is this, and we rotate the object glass towards the bottom side, downside of the point. So we can take the reading from here, and there is 8°0' in the main scale and 22nd in the vernier scale. So the total reading is 8°0' 20". You can write like this way. Instrument at A, side to P,
horizontal angle
0°0', 0", and B vernier 0', 0", and here the vertical angle, that is 8°0' 20". 8°0' 20". On the same time, you can see the vernier D, 0°0'20". And now we can rotate the instrument to point Q, and look to the top of the wooden peg and top of the nail. For that purpose, you want horizontal reading as well as vertical reading. So the before you rotate the instrument, unclamp the upper screw for horizontal reading, and I already done this thing. And after exact bisection, you can read both readings, horizontal reading as well as vertical reading. Your first reading, horizontal reading. In A scale, you can read 65°8'0". A scale. You can instrument station at A, look to Q. The degree is 65°0' in the main scale and 8°0' in the vernier scale. We add together and we got 65°8'0" in the B scale.
See.
And in this station, we can also read vertical reading. That is 7°40'20". 22nd, that is 7 degree 40 minute 20 second in the D scale. We take both reading and after unclamp the upper tangent screw, upper arresting screw, and rotate the instrument to station B. You can see the station B point after exact bisections, exact focusing. You can read the reading in the S scale. That is 119 degree 40 minute. In the vernier scale, 12 minute 20 second. Total. Instrument at A, side to B. 119 degree 52 minute 20 seconds. 52 minute 20 second in the B scale. Yes. This station setup is. On that point, we are our problem is level difference between P and Q. So in this station, we are not erected a level difference point, a wooden peg or nail there. So we conclude this station reading.